Hello everyone. Hello, I am Corinne from the tourist office of Lourdes. I am today with my colleague Anna. Hello Anna.
Hi, hello, I'm Anna from the tourist office of the Pyrenees.
And I am also with Nicole. Hello Nicole.
Hello Corinne. I'm Nicole from the tourism board on Occitanie region.
So thank you very much for joining us for this webinar about Lourdes in the Pyrenees, a must-see destination in the region Occitanie, and of course in France. First, I just want to inform you that you can ask questions during this presentation. It's very easy. You just need to go to menti.com and use the code number written on your screen, which is 31457162. Everything is written on your screen throughout the presentation. And we will try to answer as many questions as possible at the end of this presentation. But first, let's start with a short video about Lourdes in the Pyrenees in the great region of Occitanie.
Welcome to Lourdes. Lourdes is a famous spiritual place. Since in 1858, a young girl from Lourdes called Bernadette Soubirous had 18 apparitions of the Virgin Mary right here inside the sanctuary of Our Lady of Lourdes. The shrine is open every day and millions of visitors and pilgrims come every year. But Lourdes is not only a spiritual place, and I will show you all the touristic sites in the city. Let's go! Lourdes is at the heart of the Pyrenees, and now it's time to discover all the exceptional natural sites nearby. Let's go!
And Lourdes Pyrenees in the great region of Occitanie.
We are all expecting you in Lourdes, in the Pyrenees,
in Occitanie region.
Oh yes, 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 this is so, so true. We are all looking forward to welcoming you in France again. Meanwhile, thank you very, very much for attending this webinar. This webinar is part of the event Lourdes Pyrenees Rendezvous, which includes two other roundtables. One is about Lourdes as you have never seen it before, and talk about all the new innovative initiatives taken. And the second one is about Lourdes as a COVID-safe destination. So you will receive the links very shortly to watch these two conferences online in replay. Meetings will also be possible. So with Atout France offices, you will have the possibility to make appointments with us very, very shortly after this webinar. So during these two long health crises, we, Anna, Nicole, and myself, we think it's crucial to stay united and to establish new strong links or maintain a fruitful cooperation. We need to be confident in the future. French authorities are working very hard to be able to welcome this summer foreign tourists on our territory in France. We do right now have a four-stage plan for reopening, allowing foreign tourists back into France on June 9th with a sanitary passport, and a new normal way of living is expected by the end of June. So fingers crossed. But be assured that Anna, Nicole, and myself, we are here for you and here to help you now and whenever you need. I'm sure you know it. Lourdes is a place to live intimate spiritual experience in a city full of history and cultural heritage. Lourdes is located at the heart of the Pyrenees, which makes it the ideal base camp to discover all the exceptional natural sites that Anna will tell you everything later on. And Lourdes is labeled as a Grand Site Occitanie, a great site in Occitanie. It's a collection of 40 sites, which makes Lourdes a must-see destination in Occitanie and in France. And it can be the starting point or the final destination of a fabulous trip in Occitanie. So with this webinar, we hope we will give you ideas for new trips or help you in enriching the ones you already have. But without further ado, let's start this presentation with Nicole. Nicole, are you ready? It's up to you, Nicole.
Yes, yes, Corinne, I'm ready, and thank you very much. We will begin first to have some idea to visit the whole region Occitanie and to program Lourdes, Lourdes at the end or at the beginning or all the time. As you can see, the region Occitanie is in yellow and in green. So as you can see, it's a very big region. It's twice so big than Belgium in the southwest at the frontier from Spain. And on the next slide, you can see where Lourdes is localization, see, on the west part. So you, if you make program from the east part, from Provence Côte d'Azur, for example, or from Barcelona, you can cross all the region and have some great sight to see before and finish by the region of Lourdes and Pyrenees and stay some days there. On the next night, so the connection to Lourdes is easy. You have the airport, the main airport in Tarbes, Lourdes, Pyrenees, with a good connection with Paris. And in June, you will have also new connection again with Milan, with Dublin, with Rome, Cracovie, Brussels. And so you can have the possibility to come by this destination. Or also, if the time of the connection is not good with your flight, also by Toulouse, that is just localization, localized at 1 hour 30 minutes, so it's not too far. Or if you come by bus or with programmation, you can also take the freeway. That is very good if you come from any destination or also the possibility by train. It's very easy to arrive to Lourdes from Paris Montparnasse, for example. You can spend the night in Paris, visit Paris, and after arrive direct on Lourdes and visit around. On the next slide, so what can you visit in the region? So first we have two major towns that are Toulouse and Montpellier. So Toulouse is the first city in France after Paris, Lyon, Marseille. So it's the also very lively city. And also on the next slide, you can see you can have a very nice visit in Toulouse. You have three sites: UNESCO 2000 year story, the Canal du Midi, the Basilica Saint-Sernin. On the right side, it's Hôtel Dieu Saint-Jacques. It was the hospital where the pilgrims of the Saint James Way used to go. And you can make a visit of Toulouse in 2 or 3 hours, and also combine that with the visit of Airbus. And so Airbus, you can visit the factory, you can visit Aeroscopia to have all the history about the aviation, you can visit La Halle des Pionniers, and of course, maybe you saw it at the TV, we have La Cité de l'Espace, that was in connection direct because we are also a space town. And Montpellier is 2 hours from Toulouse. So you have the view on Place de la Comédie. Montpellier is very close to the Mediterranean Sea. And as you can see, it's on the next slide, it's 1,000 years old. It's a medieval, you have a lot of medieval streets, the cathedral, you can visit the museum on the medicine, 800 years old, closed also from the sea, as you can see. Very easy to arrive at the Mediterranean Sea. You can combine that with a visit of the winery, also from the Camargue. So can be also a good base, good city to stop. And also, the region, we have 8 sightseeing destinations listed on UNESCO World Heritage with, for example, the Canal du Midi. Canal du Midi is across all the region. You can rent a boat, for example, some days on the Canal du Midi, spend the night if you want. And on the next slide, Carcassonne. Carcassonne is between Montpellier and Toulouse. You have to make a stop there. It's a beautiful medieval city. As you can see on the picture, it makes a stop there. And also Rocamadour. Rocamadour is on the routes of St. James to Santiago de Compostela. Many tour operator that program Lourdes combine that with Rocamadour because of the spirituality. As you can see, you have the view on the sanctuary. Also, there is a Black Madonna, and the place is very preserved, so it can be a good base also to combine the two destinations. Close from them, you have Le Gouffre de Padirac. Gouffre de Padirac, the cave is the underground cave, the biggest cave in Europe. You can make them the visit by boat. And also, it's in the Dordogne Valley. Maybe you heard about them because they were classified first protect biosphere in Europe. So it's a very protect era, like in the Pyrenees. So that's why it's a very good combination. And on the next slide, can be combined also, for example, with Conques. Conques is on the routes of St. James to Santiago de Compostela. Can be, for example, be a stop. If you have clients, they come from Nevers, Lisieux, and they can make a stop there and see the treasure in Conques, and after make Rocamadour, Toulouse, and then arrive on Lourdes and the Pyrenees. On the next slide, Albi is just 1 hour from Toulouse. So Albi and the museum on Toulouse-Lautrec, that is the most important museum on the painter of Toulouse-Lautrec in the world. And also the cathedral, that is one of the most important meridional cathedral, Gothic in the south of France. So on the next slide, Pont du Gard. Pont du Gard is like the entrance of the region on Occitanie. It's the oldest Roman bridge in France that brings the water in the Roman period to Nîmes. So it's close to Nîmes. Nîmes is a very nice city. On the next slide that you will see, maybe you heard about Nîmes, because opened 2 years ago, the most important museum on the Roman art in France. So it's the past and the present, so can be a good base. You enter, you come from Provence Côte d'Azur, you stop in Nîmes, you visit around the Pont du Gard, Montpellier, Carcassonne, Toulouse, and you visit to finish by Gavarnie, for example, and Lourdes and Gavarnie. I don't say anything about Gavarnie, just that is wow. But Anna, this amazing place we just present in a few seconds. So on the next slide, 40 international great site. Corinne just talked about, yes, Lourdes is the pepit of this great site. And on the next slide, you have to know the region is also the most important region for the label Plus Beau Village de France. You have 45 villages classified, and we have two that were also preferred village of the French people, Saint-Cyr-la-Popie is close to Rocamadour, Cahors, so and Toulouse, and Cordes, that is close to Albi. On the next slide, 220 kilometers of Mediterranean coast. Yes, here, for example, the Camargue. And let's see on the next slide, when you come, for example, from Barcelona, you can make a stop in Collioure. And also on the next slide in Perpignan. Perpignan also is on the way. It's a town, classified towns of art and history in Occitanie. And then you have Narbonne with the beautiful cathedral. And then you arrive in Toulouse, Montauban, Auch, and again in Lourdes. See, here you have some example of tours. We have many examples of that. This one, for example, is what we just talked about, from Provence Côte d'Azur up, and you see all stops. This kind of tours we can send you with the accommodation and combine how to after finish by 2, 3, 1 week, or maybe 1 month in Lourdes. So again, on the next slide, culture. More than 300 museums and 400 festivals. On the next slide, some examples, yeah, like Pierre Soulages, Albi Museum on Toulouse-Lautrec, and also we have the wine and gastronomy. With the gastronomy, we have some foie gras, some black truffle, roquefort, oyster, and many things. That's just some example. We have 51 chefs étoilés, and we have the largest wine growing region in the world, 280,000 hectares. So as you can see, everywhere you can make a combination with a wine tour and finish even when you arrive in the region on Haute-Pyrénées and Lourdes with the Madiran and many, many, many good wine that maybe you know and that you can visit here in Occitanie. On the next slide, nature, outdoor, leader destination for walking, cycling, outdoor activities. And on the next slide, 40% of Occitanie is in protect area. 40% with the Pyrenees and the Mediterranean Sea. So really a good preservation. 38,000 for hiking, cycling. That's why the Tour de France stay 1 week in Occitanie when he come into France. So just to show you that many people want to make activities in the region. On the next slide, yes, 66 golf and also 40 ski resorts. And we are the first thermal spa region in France. But I think Anna will explain us all this new information. Hello, Anna.
Hello, Nicole, and thank you so much for this amazing presentation of Occitanie region. Okay, it's time to go to paradise. So let's go. First, we start with this map just to show you that Lourdes, as you see in this map, is very the localization of Lourdes is very, very, very important because from Lourdes you have a lot of possibilities to explore and to discover the highlights of the Pyrenees, not only in the French part but also in the Spanish part, because we are very near to the Spanish frontier. So you can combine a lot of excursion from Lourdes. As you know, it's an excellent camp base due to a lot of hotels in Lourdes. So here we are. We are in paradise. We arrive in the Pic du Midi, 2,877 meters at just 1 hour from Lourdes. It's the excursion. You have to go once in your life in the Pic du Midi. The particularity of the Pyrenees is that it's an easy access. As you see in the picture, you just take a gondola. In 15 minutes, you reach the summit of the Pic du Midi, and you have a panoramic view over the Pyrenees mountain range. It's just amazing. In this bridge, 12 meters, you have a panoramic view. It's a breathtaking panorama. So you can go in the Pic du Midi with a group of FIT. It is open all the year. And in the Pic du Midi, we have a museum dedicated to the astronomy. And we have next a planetarium, which is like an immersive cinema. And you can see movies about the history of the Pic du Midi. On the next slide, you can discover our restaurant. It can welcome 70 people, and we have menu exclusively made from premium quality, local product, excellent local product. Next, you can see the particularity of the Pic du Midi, obviously, is the purest sky in Europe, International Dark Sky Reserve. This is the largest in Europe due to the air purity, and there is no light production. Pollution. It's not a Photoshop picture. It's a reality. You can see the Milky Way. You can observe the planet, the star, the moon on the 1,000 meters of terraces. It's just amazing. Next. We have an excellent, unique product in Europe. You can spend a night in the Pic du Midi. For the honeymoon, for example, is a perfect product. It's not a hotel. It's like, you know, like high quality refuge, and you have include the dinner on the restaurant. It's excellent product for FIT or for small groups. Next. Okay, let's go to Gavarnie, UNESCO site. It's just 1 hour from Lourdes. Is a very famous excursion because it's UNESCO site. Just behind this mountain is a Spanish port. In the next slide, you can see that it's very, very easy to go in the Pyrenees everywhere in the national park landscape, very preserved. As you see, the path, it's very, very, very easy. You don't need a mountain guide to go to Gavarnie. It's just 2 hour round trip. And after Gavarnie, let's go to Côte Répond d'Espagne, which is National Park, Pyrenees National Park. It's a secret garden. It's only 40 minutes or 50 minutes from Lourdes. Very easy. And from the parking, you can arrive The particularity is, of course, the waterfall. So you can see a lot of waterfall very easily by foot, and you can reach the Lac de Gobe, or Gobe Lake, very easily by foot, of course, because you can go, it's 1 hour to reach this lake. At the bottom, you can see the Vignuma, which is one of the highest peaks in the Pyrenees. Or you have the possibility to take a chairlift and you reach the lake in 10 minutes only. Okay, let's go to the Néouliel National Nature Reserve. We cross the mountain, we take the Tourmalet Pass and the Aspin Pass, and we arrive in this wonderland. Is it an archipelago with 70 lakes in the heart of the Pyrenees? As you see, it's mountain pine trees due to his Mediterranean climate, and it's the highest mountain lakes world in the Pyrenees. So it's an excursion amazing for your groups from Lourdes. After that, after excursion, or after seeing a beautiful natural landscape reserve, let's go to the spa. We are the first spa destination in France. As you see, we have a lot of pool, outside pool with a thermal water. This one, it's Balnea. This is a onsen. I'm sure you know it. Balnea, it's the biggest spa, thermal spa in the French Pyrenees. Always you have this beautiful view on the mountain, on the Pyrenees. So it's very relaxed. It's south of France, of course. So we are very relaxed, preserved, no pollution here. So after, after relax, of course, we are in mountains. So we have a lot of activity. The more famous, it's obviously hiking destination. You have a lot of possibilities. You can make hiking by yourself without guide, or we can combine and organize some week hiking. For example, in Gavarnie, in these pictures, we can make some during 1 week. You can combine the Spanish part and the French part, because if you cross this mountain, through this mountain, you have the possibility to spend a night in a refuge and to arrive in the Spanish part. So in one product, you have two countries, but Pyrenees, it's one country. Okay, we have, of course, a lot of activities, outdoor activities, like this Via Ferrata. Some of them are very unusual. It's steep slopes like this, beautiful. We have a lot of other activities like paragliding, climbing, but also white water sports, because we have a lot of canyon. Like this, you can practice paddle in the lake. You can practice paddle in the lake near Toulouse, but Corinne, she will explain you everything. Rafting, canyoning, because we have a lot of lakes, we have a lot of river. Okay, we are cycling destination, because every year, as you know, we have the Tour de France, which is a very famous cycle race. This year in summer, we have the Tour de France during 2 days, 14 and 15 of July. The Hautes-Pyrénées has become the spot for cyclists from all over the world, especially with these famous passes like Tourmalet or Porté. Some hotels in Lourdes are specialized in cycling. So the camp base of Lourdes, which is a solution to discover all day the passes like a cycle safari. So it could be a possibility. Of course, the mountain bike destination, because we have a lot of market trial, and especially now with the e-bike, you have a lot of possibilities. Even if you are not an athlete, you can test and you can enjoy the mountain with the mountain bike. Okay, in the next slide, I want to speak about the Pyrenees identity. It's a destination with soul, because we have a lot of small villages, very typical villages. The people live all the year in the village. So if you go in the village like Lourdes or other villages, you can exchange with the local people. You can take a drink with a shepherd, with a woman, with his children. It's very friendly. It's we are happy to welcome clients. And there is a Pyrenees identity with the wine, with the Madiran wine, with the church on the way on the St. James, the Compostela, the Black Pork, the Black Pig, and the Garbure, as you see in the pictures, which is a Pyrenean soup in a small restaurant, very cozy. It's a very, very good local products and a friendly way of life. No stress here. And after that, I want to speak with you about the Pyrenees road trip, because as you see in the last map, Pyrenees, it's French Pyrenees and a Spanish Pyrenees. So for us, it's a country without frontier. It's a unique experience with natural, exceptional landscape, like Hors des Sentiers Perdus, which is like Colorado, Pyrenean Colorado, just in the opposite side of Gavarnie, Ainsa, which is one of the beautiful villages in the Spanish part with the Plaza Mayor. We are a lot of restaurants, so you can take a drink with the sangria, you can test the tapas, which is very famous, and you can visit the monastery of San Juan de la Peña, which is a monastery on the way on the Saint Jacques de Compostela, and it's built on the red rock. After that, we go in the winter time, of course, in the mountain in south of France. We are south of France ski destination, because in the mountain you can enjoy the winter time, you can practice a ski, and we have 9 ski resorts with a human scale, the very modern ski resorts with a snow guarantee. Lourdes can be a camp base for the winter time as well, because from Lourdes, you can go enjoy the ski resort. It's just 1 hour from Lourdes. So you can organize, for example, like a ski safari. Every day you can change and you can discover a new ski resort. And the last one, it's a snow activities. You don't need to practice only ski. You can just enjoy snow activities like dog sledding or snowshoes trips. You can enjoy, you can relax after the activities in the spa, because they are open all the year, or just enjoy this beautiful landscape. Okay, now it's time to Corinne to explain everything about Lourdes. So I give the floor to Corinne. It's your moment, Corinne.
thank you very much, Anna, for this very interesting presentation of the Pyrenees. Next, you will see on the map that, as Anna told you, Lourdes is very well located near exceptional sites all around. I'm sure now you are convinced that you can program a star circuit with daily excursions from Lourdes over several days to visit the Pic du Midi, Neuville, Côte aux Répons d'Espagne, Gavarnie, which are, as Lourdes, labeled Grand City in Occitanie. So within an hour, you have 5 great sites in Occitanie to visit. So a very rich environment. But first and foremost, Lourdes is the ideal place to live a spiritual experience. I'm sure most of you, all of you, know that. When you are in Lourdes, you quickly embrace the spiritual atmosphere of the place. It's a very peaceful place for a powerful and very rewarding experience. Everything started in 1858 when the young girl you see on your screen, Bernadette Soubirous, had 18 apparitions of the Virgin Mary right there at the Grotto of the Apparitions. The Catholic Church very quickly built a shrine at the place of the apparitions called the Sanctuary of Our Lady of Lourdes. The shrine is open every day, so you can come from January to December, whenever you want. And the access is free and unrestricted. You can stay as long as you want inside, and you can come as many times as you want as well. Of course, Lourdes crowds are mainly Catholics, but not only, other religion too. Everyone is welcome in Lourdes. Next, so the main place inside the shrine is obviously the Grotto of the Apparitions. So people go inside the grotto to feel the rock and also to pray in front of the statue of the Virgin Mary, next, right where the young Bernadette saw her in 1858, for a very emotional moment for pilgrims. Next, the sanctuary is a big domain of 52 hectares surrounded by nature, as you can see. As I told, the grotto is the heart of the sanctuary. Above the grotto, you have the crypt, which was built right after the apparitions. Inside the crypt, you can pray and see Saint Bernadette's relics. Above the crypt, you have the Immaculate Conception Basilica, which was built in 1871, so very quickly after the apparitions. Inside this basilica, you have stained glass windows telling the story of the apparitions. Below, you have the Rosary Basilica. The Rosary Basilica, its style is influenced by Byzantine architecture, and inside you have 15 chapels like this ones, all covered with mosaics, with a central image, and these mosaics tell the story of the mysteries of the Rosary. And they were made by a famous artist of that time called Facchina, an Italian artist, and this artist, Facchina, also made masterpieces of mosaics inside the Garnier Opera in Paris, for instance. And there is a third basilica. There are more than 20 places of worship inside the shrine, and three basilicas, which is quite unique in the world. And the third basilica is a St. Pius X Basilica, and it's a green oval you have on the left-hand side of your screen. It's an underground basilica, which is unique. And inside this huge basilica, next, you can see you can gather a lot of people, up to 25,000 people can attend at the same time a mass. And the shrine organizes international masses every Wednesday and Sunday mornings. And these masses are said in different languages at the same time. And there are six official languages inside the shrine: French, Italian, Spanish, Dutch, German, and of course, English. So you have different masses every day in these languages. Signs are essential in Lourdes. The water of Lourdes is quite famous because it's associated to all the miracles that have occurred or are linked to Lourdes. So far, 70 unexplained cured have been recognized as miracles in Lourdes. And the spring you see in the middle of the image is inside the grotto of the apparitions. During one of the apparitions, the Virgin Mary asked the young Bernadette to dig the soil and drink the water that she would find. And it's the same water that you can still drink today, and you can still see the spring inside the grotto of the apparitions. You can do the water gesture also, or be plunged, immersed into the same water in the bath, which is very, very important for pilgrims and a very intimate and very emotional experience when in Lourdes. Light is also omnipresent through the millions and millions of candles burned for more than 160 years, and also next with the candlelight procession. I'm sure all of you who have come to Lourdes, I'm sure you have done the procession. This procession takes place every night from April around Easter. It starts around Easter until the end of October. So everyone gathers inside the sanctuary with a candle to sing and pray together for approximately 1 hour. Next, so this is the highlight of a stay in Lourdes. So if you come to Lourdes, if you send pilgrims or visitors to Lourdes, you should advise them to see or do the procession, because it's a very emotional moment, very energy giving, and really a moment that no one should miss when in Lourdes. There is also another procession every day, same period from April till end of October. At 5 p.m., it's a Blessed Sacrament procession, the Eucharistic procession. Next, when you are in Lourdes, you can follow also Saint Bernadette's footsteps inside the city, following a pedestrian path. You can go to the Bolimille, where she was born and spent her first 10 years. Then go to the Cachot, that's where she lived with her family at the time of the apparitions. In the parish church, you will find the baptismal fonts where Bernadette was baptized. At the presbytery, you can go and see where she met the priest during the apparitions to tell him what was happening to her. And the hospices is where she had her first communion and where she took refuge after the apparitions with the Sister of Charity of Nevers. You can also visit Lourdes with a little tourist train, which is very practical. And you can visit different museums like Wax Museum or the Lourdes Little Museum. And the little tourist train also serves the castle. And this fortified fortress houses a Pyrenean Museum. It's a museum about the traditions, costume, furniture, paintings of the Pyrenees on both sides, the French side and the Spanish side. As you have seen with Anna, Lourdes is very close to the border, which is the Pyrenees. The Pyrenees are the natural border between France and Spain. And inside the museum and the castle, you have a botanical garden, a small chapel. And as you can see, you also have models of architecture of the Pyrenees from the Catalonia country to the Basque country. So from the west to the, from the east of the Pyrenees to the west of the Pyrenees. Next. The little tourist train also serves the funicular of Pic du Gers. Pic du Gers is the small mountain in the city of Lourdes. So within 10 minutes, you can reach the top of the Pic du Gers, and from the top, you have this view, a splendid view over the city of Lourdes and the surroundings, and also over all the Pyrenean peaks around Lourdes. You have a restaurant also at the top and a natural cave that you can visit. And as you see on this image, the site has already hosted 3 World Cups of mountain biking and will host another one in March 2022. So as Anna told you, you can do a lot of mountain biking and cycling in the Pyrenees and of course, in Lourdes also. The Lourdes Lake is at 3 kilometers of the city center. It's a very peaceful place for a picnic or for watching the sunset. You can also do canoeing, paddleboarding, and along the lake, you have a golf course. There is a golf in Lourdes also. It's an 18-hole golf course. After that, or before, you can have a stop at the marketplace, which is open every day also. And it's the best place to buy some souvenirs from Lourdes of typical products of the Pyrenees, like black pork of Bigorre, like cheese of the Pyrenees, honey, or some foie gras from the southwest of France, or some bottles of Madiron, our red wine in Haute-Pyrénées. Next. So Lourdes is also a place, the place to stay with accommodation with excellent price quality ratio. You find every kind of accommodation and for all budget, hotels, campings, B&Bs, furniture rental properties, and for all types of clients, FITs, families, coupled, cyclists, hikers, touristic groups, and obviously spiritual groups. Lourdes has the second largest hotel capacity in France after Paris, with 132 hotels up to 5 stars. So from small, cozy, family-owned hotels to modern and luxurious ones. Accommodation in Lourdes have improved a lot and keep improving every year, offering new services like spas, as you can see, fitness centers, swimming pools, new activities. Lourdes welcome people from all over the world, as you know it, maybe. International standards are well-known, as well as the habits and expectation of each and every country. And for the past months, everyone have followed and keep following COVID-safe measures, placing the highest value on protecting our clients and your clients, of course. To conclude, we want to show you some ideas of packages available to you on a star secret basis, so all nights in Lourdes and with daily excursions with different activities like spas, like wine tasting, visits of the amazing natural sites all around, and activities for children. For instance, you have a 2 days, two nights package, including Lourdes, the sanctuary, the visit of the city, and the treasure, the jewel at 1 hour of Lourdes, which is Gavarnie. Another package is 3 days, three nights, including Lourdes, Gavarnie, and Côte-Répond d'Espagne, and the access to a beautiful spa, Les Bains du Rocher, with an outside swimming pool, inside swimming pool, and the outside swimming pool has a splendid view over the mountains. Another package, 4 days, four nights, so Lourdes, Gavarnie, Côte-Répond d'Espagne, and the amazing Pic du Midi, really the must-see when you are in Lourdes. You have to go to the Pic du Midi observatory. And a full week dedicated to families with children activities like animal parks, small, easy hiking in Gavarnie, and a lot of things to do and visit around Lourdes. These packages, of course, can be tailor-made. These are just ideas, and they all can be adapted to your expectations or your clients' needs. And with Anna and Nicole, we can work closely together to help you in creating your own packages in Lourdes Pyrénées and in Occitanie. You have our emails and phone number on your screen, so you can register them on your phone and on your computer, and feel free to send us emails, WhatsApp messages, you can call us whenever you need. We are at your entire disposition to help you, of course. I think it's time now to see if we have some questions. Do we have a few questions?
No questions for the moment. Just some thanks for this exciting program, but no question.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for attending this webinar. Of course, we are also at your disposal to welcome you for a fam trip. We can organize, and we do organize, and we will organize as soon as it will be possible, a fam trip, tailor-made fam trip for you. So we can work closely on a program before your arrival, and we will stay with you and be your guide during your stay. And we can also, well, be at your disposition whenever you want. Would you like to add something, Anna?
Sorry, no, I want just to thank you again. I was very happy to make this presentation of the Pyrenees, and I hope to see you soon in the Pyrenees with Corinne and Nicole, and to share with you all this good energy in Lourdes, and visited with you and with your clients the all amazing natural site in the Pyrenees. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Anna. Nicole, a last word?
Last word, just to say that we are all ready to welcome you and your client in the region Occitanie, in Lourdes Pyrénées. So we thank you very much for this presentation, to be here with us today. Goodbye.
Thank you. Thank you, Nicole. Thank you, Anna. Thank you all. We really miss you, and we hope we will see you and meet you in real next time. Thank you again, and a special thoughts to our Indian friends and partners during this difficult time. Our heart goes out to you and to you all. So see you soon in Lourdes Pyrénées, in Occitanie, and see you soon in France. Bye-bye.